In this video, we're going to be looking at practices on graphing absolute value function. If you find this video helpful, share, like, and subscribe. Okay, let's do some practices on absolute value functions. Here, we are going to identify the vertex. Determine if the graph opens up or down. You have to circle that one. Determine if the graph has a maximum or minimum, circle that also, and its value. Decide if the graph is narrower, wider, or the same width as the parent graph, and you can also circle that part. Okay, let's start with number one. Y is equal to negative absolute value of x plus 1. What's going to be the vertex? The vertex is going to be negative 1 and then 0. I cannot see anything here, so it's going to be 0. So since there is a negative in front, that's going to tell me that it's going to open down. Okay, the maximum, do I have a maximum or a minimum? Since it's going to be opening down, then I have a maximum of 0. Will it be narrower, wider, or the same? Since there is nothing in front of it, only negative 1, then that's going to be the same. Next, number 2. Y is equal to 7 times absolute value of x minus 3 minus 4. So these are our vertex coordinates. That's going to be 3 and negative 4. Okay, I can see that the 7 in there is positive. So this is going to go up. Okay, so when A is positive, here it's going to be positive, then it's going to go up. When A is negative, it's going to be going down. Also, I would like to tell something in here, that when you're going to have your when it's opening up just like this one, your vertex is actually at its minimum. Okay, this is your minimum. And when your graph is going to be opening down just like this one, your vertex is actually at maximum. Okay, so my graph is going to be opening up, so this is going to have a minimum. Okay, a minimum value of negative 4. Okay, so since there is 7, that is why my A here is greater than 1, then it's going to have a vertical stretch. Okay, it means to say that it's going to be narrower. Okay, let's go for number 3. Here, number 3, y is equal to negative. Negative again, so it's going to be opening down. 2 over 3 times the absolute value of x minus 1. Now, we cannot see any plus k in here. It means to say that's going to be 0. So, this is going to give you 1 and 0 as your vertex. And since there is a negative in here, okay, take note of this negative sign in here. Then, that's going to tell me that it's going to be opening down. And when it's going to be opening down, it means to say that my vertex is at its maximum. And the value of that maximum is going to be 0. It's going to be 0 when x is equal to 1. Okay, so this number, 2 over 3, is actually less than 1. Okay, so we said in our class that when your A is less than 1, then that's going to have a vertical shrink. Okay, it's a vertical shrink. It means to say that it's going to be going nearer to the x-axis. This will cause the graph to be wider. Okay, let's go for the next one. Number 4. Y is equal to 5 over 2 times the absolute value of x plus 9 minus 1. So first, I have seen again here my A. 5 over 2 is greater than 1. A is positive. Okay, therefore, it's going to open up. And then my A again is greater than 1. Then this is going to give me a narrower. This is going to be narrower. Okay, so my vertex now is located at, let's change the sign of that. It's going to give you negative 1, and this one retains its sign. That's going to be negative 1. So since my A here is 5 over 2, it means to say that it's going to be opening up. And when it's going to be opening up, my vertex is at its minimum. And the minimum value of my vertex here is going to be negative 1. So because you have A is greater than 1, then the graph will become narrower. Okay, let's go to number 5. Number 5, I've seen my A in here once again. It's 3 over 4. So what does that tell me? My A here is less than 1. So it's going to become wider in nature. And also my A is positive, then it's going to go up. And when it's going to be opening up, then my vertex is at its minimum. Okay, so the vertex of this is going to be, change the sign of that. It's going to give you negative 3, negative 6. So it's going to be opening up because my A here is positive. Then I have a minimum value of negative 6. As for my graph, because 3, 4 is less than 1, then it will become wider. Okay, let's go to number 6. Number 6 is y is equal to negative absolute value of x plus 5. So I've seen my negative in here. My A is negative. It means to say that it's going to open downwards. Okay, it's going to open down. And also, since my A is, the value of my A is only 1, okay, then it's going to have the same shape like the parent function. So my vertex is going to be located at 0 and then 5. It's going to open down because of the negative in there in front. And since it's going to be opening down like this, then your vertex is actually at its maximum. And the maximum value of that is going to be 5, okay? It's going to give you 5 when x is 0, okay? Okay, earlier, so we said a is only 1 in here, so it's going to have the same shape like the parent function. Okay, let's go to the next one. Neatly graph each absolute value function. Okay, so our vertex here is located at 3. That's gonna give you 3 and then 0. Okay, why there is no 0 in here? So earlier in our class, I told you that this is going to be your slope, just like when you're going to be using the slope to graph your slope intercept form equations. We're going to use the same idea in here, okay? Okay, so let's plot our vertex. The vertex is located at 3, 0. Where is my 3, 0? My 3, 0 is in here. Again, and then how will I get my first point? My slope here is 3 over 1. It means to say, remember your slope, that's going to be rise over run. It means to say that in this case, I have 3 over 1. It means to say that I'll be going up 3 and I will be going right 1. So let's do that. So from the vertex, let me just say 3, 0. That's your vertex. I'll go up 3. 1, 2, 3. And then I'll go 1 right. So this is my second point. Sorry, my first point. One more. 1, 2. 1, 2, 3. And then here again. So if I'm going to connect that, okay, it's not a perfect straight line, but at least you have the idea there. That is now the first part of my graph. Now, remember that this graph is actually symmetric to its vertex. So the distance from this first point to the symmetric line is going to just be 1, therefore that's going to be the same also with this. So from the center going to this point on the left side, it's going to be a mirror. So that's going to be my next point in there. So from here, you have actually 2 points in there. It means to say that you're going to also have 2 points from the middle to the next in here. So if I'm going to connect this one right now, then I just have created or drawn my graph for this function. Okay, so it's going to open up because the 3 in here is positive. Okay, number 8. Number 8, I can actually see here a negative in here. negative absolute value of x plus 4. So it does that negative sign in front is going to tell me that it's going to be opening down this way. So my vertex is going to be at its maximum. Okay, so let's look at this one. What's going to be our vertex here? Our vertex is located at 0 and then 4. And the slope is 1. So my slope is equal to negative 1 and 1. It means to say that it's going to be going down this way. Okay, let's do that. Okay, so 0, 4. Where's my 0, 4? 0, 4 is here. Okay, that's going to be my vertex, 0, 4. And then I'm going to use my slope. I'll go down 1, 1. And then I'm going to turn right 1. I'll do the same thing again. This one. Then do again. Okay. So these are my main points. So if I'm going to create now my line, then it's going to be going this way. Okay. Now, as I said earlier, this is going to be symmetric from the vertex. Okay. So this is going to be 1 unit. And in here, it's going to be 2. And this is going to be 3. So we only need few points. And then we're going to connect everything in there. And voila, we're done with our graphing. Okay, the next one. Number 9. What does it tell me again? I saw a negative again in there. It means to say that it's going to be opening down again. So where are my vertex located? My vertex is located at negative 3 and 5. Okay? So if you see negative 3 within that absolute value sign, you have to change it into negative. Okay, so let's plot negative 3, 5. Where's our negative 3 and 5? Negative 3 is here, and then my 5 is up there. So this is going to be my vertex, which is negative 3 and then 5. So since it's negative, it should be going down. Now the slope again is going to be 1. That's going to give you negative 1 over 1. It means to say it's going to go down 1, and it's going to go right 1 unit. So let's do that one. So I'm going to go down here and then go right again. So this is going to be my next point. Down again. That's my next point. Down again. That's my next point. Okay, so let me just connect this one first. So this is going to be going this way. And the other side is going to be the same thing. Remember, they are symmetric. It means to say that it's going to mirror this line on this side of your graph is going to be the mirror on the other side. So this is going to be this point. They are equidistant from the center. So it's going to be there and one more in there. So if I'm going to draw my graph, then voila, I'm done. Okay, let's go for the next one, number 10. Number 10, I can see a positive in there. So my graph is going to be opening up. Okay, but my vertex is going to be located at negative 1 and negative 1. My slope here is 2 over 1. It means that I'm going to rise 2 and I'm going to run right 1 unit. Okay, so let's find our vertex. Vertex is negative 1, negative 1. It's going to be here. This is going to be our vertex, negative 1 and negative 1. Our slope is 2. So we're going to say 1, 2, and then here, that's going to be my first point. Another one, 1, 2, and then this one. Another one, if you like, 1, 2, then voila, we did it already. So let's just connect it. Connect, okay, there you go. And don't forget that this is actually a mirror on the other side. So this is going to be on that point. This point is going to be on this point. That's going to be total of 2 units here, then 2 units there also. And this is going to be from the center is 1, 2, 3. So here go 1, 2, and 3. So this is going to be the places where your line is going to be connected towards that. Okay? So voila, I'm done. Okay, number 11. Oh, this is very nice. The slope is 4 over 3. So my slope is 4 over 3. It means to say that I'm going to go up 4 units up, and then I'm gonna go 3 units to the right. Now where is our vertex here? Our vertex is at negative 2 and then negative 5. Okay, vertex is negative 2 and then negative 5. So let's put that up. Where's our negative 2? Negative 2 is somewhere here, and then it says negative 5, so I'll go down more. So this is my vertex. Vertex is negative 2, negative 5. So my slope is 4 over 3. I'll go 4 up, 1, 2, 3, and 4, and then I'll go 3 to the right, 1, 2, and 3. So this is my next point. If I'm going to go and extend that more, 1, 2, 3, and 4, then 1, 2, and 3, this is going to be my next. Okay, so I'm going to connect it first. Okay, that's the one, and then connect it again. I'll extend now. So I have my symmetric line in here, if I'm going to look at that. So from this point to the middle, that's going to be 1, 2, 3. That's going to be 3, because we're going to be turning 3 on the right. So on the left, do the same thing. So 1, 2, and 3, it's going to go here. Okay, so that's going to be, let's check it, 1, 2, and 3. Okay, that's correct already. Okay, let's just draw it until it's going to go out, because the place where I'm going to put my graph is really very small. Okay, so voila, you have done that exactly if you did exactly how I did it. Okay, next, number 12. Oh, what I've seen in here is the negative immediately. It means to say that my graph is going to be opening down, and my slope in here is going to be negative 3 over 2. It means to say that I'm going to be going down 3, and I'm going to be turning right 2 units. My vertex is located at 3 and then 2. Okay, so where's 3 and 2? 3, 2 is somewhere here. Okay, remember, this is our vertex, and our slope is going to be negative 3 over 2. So we're going to go down 3 units, 1, 2, and 3, and then turn right 2 units, 1 and 2. Okay, so this is going to be my next point. Okay, so I'm going to do the same thing again, but this time I'm going to turn left. Okay, see, 1, 2, 3, and then 1 and 2. Okay, so this is going to be the place where I'm going to connect my points. Okay, I'll be connecting it now, and it's going to go this way, and the other way, one is going to be this way. Okay, so in this next activity, write the equation of the graph, then give its range as an inequality. Okay, let's start with number 13. Okay, so let's first look at our vertex. The vertex is located where? It's actually located at negative 1 and 2. Okay, so is there anything I can see? If I'm going to get one point from here, and I'll go up and turn, that's going to be the slope here, is going to be 1. So there's no problem. My graph is opening up, so this should have a positive value of A, which is 1. So Y here is going to be the absolute value of X minus H plus K. Okay, let's put our values. That's going to be X minus minus 1 is plus 2. Simplify further, that's going to give you y is equal to x plus 1 plus 2. Okay, that is our equation. What about the range? Okay, the range, the lowest that we can get here is actually the y value of this. So that's going to give you the range. Now it says here in our instruction that put it as an inequality. So we say that when you say that, it's going to be, the range is going to be y should be greater equal to 2. Okay, that is an inequality. Okay, the next one, the vertex now is actually located at negative 3 and then negative 2. Okay, it's the slope is going to be, if I'm going to get this one, I went down, and from here, my slope is actually negative 1 over 1. Okay, so y is equal to a x minus h plus k. Okay, our a here is negative, so let's suggest negative, then x, our value of the value of our x is going to be negative 3, and then plus negative 2. So if we're going to simplify all of these, it's going to give you negative negative multiplied by a negative is going to give you positive, so x is going to be x plus 3. Positive multiplied by a negative is going to give you negative 2. Okay, so the highest we can get in here so far is the y should be lesser or equal to negative 2. So it means to say that it's going to go through positive infinity. Okay, let's go for the next one. Number 15. Where is the vertex located? The vertex is located at 2, 3. Okay? What about my slope? If I'm going to choose this point, these two points, I can say 1 and 2 and then 1. So, because it's opening down, that's going to be negative 2 over 1, or simply negative 2. Okay, so let's put in to our equation. Y is equal to A, X minus H plus K. So Y is equal to negative 2 in here. X minus 2 only. And then plus 3. Okay, so this is our equation in there. What about our range? Okay, so since the highest we can get in here is going to be 3 only, then that's going to be... And then going down, the value is going down to negative infinity, then our range should be just not equal. It should be lesser. Lesser equal to 3. Okay, that's going to be your range. Okay, so number 16. So let's first look at our vertex in here. The vertex here is located at this one. That's negative 2, negative 3. Okay, and our slope, if I'm going to get one perfect point in here, it's going to be this one. So I'll go up one unit, and then I'll run two units. So that's going to give you a slope of 1 over 2. Okay, so let's put our equations together. Y is equal to 1/2, that's gonna give you absolute value of x minus minus 2, then minus 3. Okay, simplifying further, y is equal to 1/2 x plus 2 minus 3. Okay, so our range is going to be, the lowest we can get here is actually negative 3, so it's going to be greater equal to negative 3. Okay, that's how you're going to do it. Okay, let's go for the next one. Number 17, the equation is really very nice again in here. Okay, so let's look at it's negative, it's going down, I mean it's opening down, so that's gonna give you a negative slope. Okay, let me just first look at my vertex. My vertex is actually located at 1 and then 0. Yeah. Okay, what about my slope? My slope is, if I'm gonna get a perfect point in here, it's gonna be this point. Okay, that the point located at 5 and negative 3. So if I'm gonna go down, okay, if I'm gonna look at the slope of this to that part, I can go down 1, 2, 3. That's gonna be 3 units down, and then 1, 2, 3, 4. It's going to be 4 units to the right. So that's going to give me a negative 3 over 4 as my slope. Okay, so here, let's put things now. Y is equal to negative 3 over 4, absolute value of x minus 1 only. And then, because it's 0, we don't have to put plus 0 in here. We don't have to put that, okay? We just have to just leave it as it is. So this is your equation for this. And the highest that we can get in here is going to be 0. Okay, so that should be, our range here now is going to be, y should be lesser equal to 0. Okay, because this is going to go down to the negative infinity. Now next, number 18. Number 18 is going to be interesting again. Okay, first let me check the vertex. The vertex is located at 0, negative 2. 0, negative 2. And look at my slope in here. I'm going to get one perfect points in here. That's just the one. I can actually go up 1, 2, 3, 4. That's going to be 4. And then 1 down, or simply 4. So that's going to be as easy peasy now. So y is equal to 4, absolute value of x minus 0. That's going to be just like give you x. And then minus 2. So this is your equation. So the range, the lowest that we can find in here is going to be negative 2. So y should be greater or equal to negative 2. So this is your range. So this is all on the practices on graphing absolute value function that we have done in our classroom. I hope this is going to help you understand more on our current lessons on graphing absolute value functions. If you find this video helpful, share, like, and subscribe. Thank you very much.